हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द साइंस क्लास ऑफ फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ चैप्टर सॉलिड्स लिक्विड्स एंड गैसेस। आई होप यू हैव रेड एंड रिवाइज्ड द टॉपिक सॉल्यूशंस दैट आई हैव डिस्कस्ड विद यू इन माय प्रीवियस क्लास। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे माय टॉपिक इज सेपरेशन ऑफ लिक्विड्स, सो ओपन योर बुक एट पेज 74। स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड that there are two types of substances, that is soluble substance and insoluble substance. So depending upon the types of substances, there are different methods of separation of liquids. Methods like sedimentation, decantation and filtration are used to separate insoluble solids from liquids, and the methods like evaporation and condensation are used to separate soluble solids from liquids, and distillation is used for separation of liquids from miscible liquids. Students, today we will discuss separation of liquids from insoluble solids, and the method used in this separation are sedimentation, decantation and filtration. Firstly, we will discuss sedimentation and decantation. So let's read from your book. During sedimentation, the insoluble component of the mixture settles at the bottom of the liquid. Students, underline word component and write its meaning. One of several parts of which something is made. Now underline word settle and write its meaning. To come to order or rest. Now underline word sedimentation and write its definition. The process of settling down of heavier particles at the bottom of container due to gravity. So students, during sedimentation, the heavier particles settle at the bottom of the liquid. Let's take example of muddy water. If we take muddy water in a beaker, the particles of mud settle down at the bottom of container if they remain undisturbed for some time. Now the insoluble solid component, that is mud, which settle down at the bottom of liquid is called sediment. So student, definition of sediment is the heavier particles that settles at the bottom of the container. So students, the clear liquid above the sediments is called supernatant. Now students, the supernatant, that is clear liquid, is then poured into another container without disturbing the sediments, and this process is called decantation. So what is decantation? Decantation is the process of pouring clear water into another container without disturbing the sediments. Now next method of separation of insoluble solids is filtration. So let's read. The technique by which insoluble solid particles of a liquid mixture are separated by passing through a filter is called filtration. Now students, underline word technique and write its meaning, a particular way of doing something. Now students, the definition of filtration is the process of separating insoluble substances from the solution by using the filter paper. So in the process of filtration, the liquid having insoluble substances are separated by passing through filter paper. The component that remain behind on the filter paper is called residue, and the liquid that pass through the filter paper is called the filtrate. Now students, underline word remains and write its meaning, what is left behind. Now underline word filter paper. Now what is filter paper? Filter paper is a type of porous paper used for separating solids from liquids. Now underline word residue and write its meaning, the insoluble solid particles left on the filter paper. Now underline word filtrate and write its meaning, clear liquid that has passed through a filter paper. So students, after filtration, insoluble solids are separated from the liquids. So students, today we have discussed about separation of liquids from insoluble solids and the three methods used for separation, that is sedimentation, decantation and filtration. In the next class, we will continue with separation of liquids from soluble solids and the method involved in these separation. Till then, you read and revise this topic again and also related cross questions. Thank you. Have a nice day.